Curaçao and Roatan, Honduras. Both are awesome places offering a variety of excellent attributes. In today's video, however, we're going to compare for you the differences based on how we saw them living in Roatan for 3 months and Curaçao for 6 months. Hi, my name is Aaron Miller and this is Plan Free. If you're new here, welcome. Feel free to press the like and subscribe buttons if you want to see more videos on topics like this. If you're interested to learn more about how we created the lifestyle we live today, you can check out our sister channel, Plan Free Finance and Abundance. Roatan, Honduras and Curaçao have many similarities, but in today's video, we're going to try to point out some of the differences for you. If you're the type of person that needs to choose between one or the other for your next vacation, hopefully this video will help you do that. In a perfect world, you're able to visit both of these places, Roatan and Curaçao, for an extended period of time to enjoy them both. But if you do need to select one, hopefully this can get you started. Let's begin by talking about something almost everyone is interested in, and that is beaches. Obviously, both Roatan and Curaçao are islands, and in basically their entire coastline is surrounded by water and to a certain degree beaches. What you'll find is that on Roatan, you've got beautiful gradual beaches and specifically on the west side, some world-class sunsets. In the case of Curaçao, however, being a much larger island, just simply by mass, you have a greater number of beaches and correspondingly a greater diversification within those beaches. Some are windy for water sports, some are secluded and calm for swimming and snorkeling. Some have fantastic gradual sandy beaches with beautiful turquoise Caribbean waters. Others are rocky, some offer cliff diving. In respect to beaches as a standalone, I would have to give Curaçao the edge just simply because of the aforementioned diversity and number of beaches that they have. Also, from a picturesque standpoint, it's pretty tough to beat Caribbean waters like Curaçao has. All right, next we'll talk about size and population. Checking notes to appear smarter than I am otherwise. Roatan is 32 square miles, while Curaçao is 171 square miles. So Curaçao is significantly larger, multiple times actually. But when it comes to population, they're much closer than that. With Roatan having a population of 110,000 people compared to Curaçao's 164,000 people. Logically, you would think that Roatan, having a higher population density, would be more crowded and corresponding more, you know, let's say traffic congestion or traffic jams. But we didn't find that to be the case. And I think it might be because the population in Curaçao is so concentrated in Willemstad proper that Curaçao does experience significant traffic congestion. Whereas I think the population in Roatan is slightly more dispersed and therefore the traffic in Roatan seemed to flow a little bit better in our observation than it did in Curaçao. In Roatan, they're still concentrated people-wise in the Cox and Hole area, but maybe not quite as concentrated as in Curaçao's Willemstad area. In Curaçao, once you get out of Willemstad, because there's very few people, the roads now become a pleasure to drive with very few vehicles passing either way, so driving is quite easy. Snorkeling, free diving, and scuba. Both Roatan and Curaçao offer these activities, and both of them have quite decent reefs and wildlife available. I would give the edge to Roatan in this case because they have a vibrant reef surrounding the entire island that's easily accessible even from shore. You can walk off or flipper off in many places of the island. A few kicks later and you're on one of the best reefs that we've ever seen. And further to that, Roatan is one of the most inexpensive places that we know about that you can go ahead and get your PADI certification. I think one of the other most inexpensive places to do that would be Bali, Indonesia. So when you take the health and vibrance of Roatan's reef and couple it with the low price of getting a PADI certification, I think Roatan, with the free diving, snorkeling, and scuba diving, has the clear edge in this category. Cost of living. Neither of these places, Roatan or Curaçao, are particularly inexpensive as far as cost of living goes. However, between the two, Roatan has a lower cost of living than does Curaçao. Curaçao is rather expensive, really. Now, on the flip side of that, Curaçao has a better variety of goods and services. Like, so for example, when you go to the grocery store, you'll see a much wider array of things available in Curaçao than you will in Roatan. However, you do pay for that variety in the case of Curaçao. So Roatan, lower cost of living, maybe less products and services available. Curaçao, higher cost of living, more products and services available. Just to clarify this point though, when we stayed in Roatan for 3 months, it didn't feel like we were lacking a whole bunch of products and services, but there is a significant increase in variety if you were to go from Roatan to Curaçao. Climate and rainfall. Both of these islands are in tropical areas of the world, so climate most of the time is going to be pleasant and warm. Overall, I would say that seasonally dependent, Curaçao is slightly warmer than Roatan. For example, in conjunction, the next point is rainfall. Roatan will receive significantly more rain than Curaçao. Even though it does rain sometimes in Curaçao, it's usually a burst or two in the afternoon, and then most of the time it's over. Whereas Roatan, you will get full-on rainy days, like a day at a time, or maybe multiple days at a time in its rainy season. So correspondingly, when it's rainy in Roatan, it's going to be cooler than it would be, you know, the same sort of season in Curaçao. Overall though, however, we would say that rain wasn't a dominant factor in either Roatan or Curaçao. Both of them would be categorized more as, you know, rain showers or spurts of rain interspersed throughout the day. They get significantly less rain in both of these spots than say Colombia, Panama, or Costa Rica would. Spoken languages. In both Roatan and Curaçao, Spanish is widely spoken. And in the case of Curaçao, Dutch is also spoken widely, as is Papiamento. But probably what you're most interested in if you're watching this video is what is the prevalence of English being spoken in either spot? And so that's what I'll touch on here. In Roatan, English is, I would say, fairly widely spoken, especially in the tourist areas, the resorts. You know, if you're receiving medical attention, that sort of thing, most of those folks will be able to speak English. However, there are large areas and sectors of the population that won't speak any English. So for example, if you were to drive up to the less populated areas of Roatan, most of the time English will be a little bit harder to come by and sometimes not at all. When you compare that with Curaçao, pretty much everyone on Curaçao can speak English or at least communicate, you know, in a rough form with an English-based communication set. So in comparing the two, Roatan, you will definitely get into spots where there's no English spoken and you will either need some Spanish or communicating will be a little bit cumbersome. In Curaçao, you can pretty much go anywhere and be able to communicate some way, shape, or form in English. If you've watched a few of our other videos here at Plan Free, or you've been following us for a little while, you know that we tend towards slow travel, where we will relocate to a country and live there anywhere between 3 and 6 months. So the topic of visitor visa allowance is important to us, and if you're also slow traveling, it will be important to you. In Roatan, the standard allowance for visitor visa stay was 90 days for Canadians, and you can check your country correspondingly, but it's most likely going to be 90 days. Compared to Curaçao, Curaçao allows 30 days standard, and with some applications, some proving of some bank accounts, and giving the Curaçao government money, you can extend that to an additional 60 days. So with some rigmarole, time, effort, and money, you can get to the 90 days that Roatan gives you right out of the gate. But if it was me and I was comparing one to one, which country gives me a longer visa allowance for the least amount of time and effort, Roatan clearly wins out here, because as soon as you touch the soil, they give you 90 days, Curaçao gives you 30. In summary, both of these places, Roatan, Honduras, and Curaçao, are excellent candidates for your next holiday. If you like things like sunny, beautiful beaches, very good to excellent snorkeling, scuba, a warm climate. Everyone has personalized interests that are kind of unique to them. If it was me, having spent significant amounts of time in each country. If I had to choose one to go back to live in or stay for, let's say, 6 months, it wouldn't be an easy decision because each country has certain things that are very valuable to me. For example, Curacao has much less rain. It's a little bit warmer. It has a more diverse availability as far as beaches go and a wider array of products and services. On the flip side of that, Roatan has a little bit better wildlife, a little bit lower cost of living, and they have better scuba and freediving with their vibrant reef available. It would be tough to choose between the two, but I think all things put together, if I had to choose one or the other, I would probably go back and live in Roatan. Especially when I consider that Roatan offers me a 90-day visa stay without any obligations right out of the gate. My name's Aaron Miller and this is Plan Free. If you like the video, press the like button and subscribe. Hit the blue bell icon to always be notified when we're coming out with the next video. Thank you for watching. We'll see you again soon. Bye for now.